Yeah, here we go. This is a really good one.
Hello, I'm Bob Hartzler, Extension Weed Scientist at Iowa State University, and today we're in the agronomy teaching greenhouses, and we're going to talk about identifying three weedy vines. And we're going to look at them at the seedling stage, although most people probably don't encounter these until they're larger in the vines. But I think one of the points to emphasize is that if you know the characteristics of a plant, you should be able to identify it even in the seedling stage or as an adult. So the first one we'll look at is one of the morning glories. And so this is ivy leaf morning glory. And you can see it has these unique butterfly shaped, some people call them saddle shaped, but they're cotyledons with two deep lobes. And that's something very common in the morning glory family, the Convolvulaceae family. They have these lobed cotyledons. And so this is ivy leaf morning glory. Later on, the leaves have deep lobes. This first true leaf isn't really lobed, but if you look at this one that's just starting to open up, I think maybe you can see that it will have the deep lobes to it. So that's ivy leaf morning glory. That's an annual. Now this is another Convolvulaceae, so the morning glory family, but this is a perennial. And so most people rarely see the field bindweed as a seedling. They usually find it when it's developing from its underground rootstocks, and that's what makes this weed so difficult to manage, is the rootstocks can go 6 feet deep in the soil, and if you want to kill an infestation of the field bindweed, you need to kill that entire root system. That can be difficult. So here, these are the cotyledons, and unfortunately this particular individual doesn't have the lobes, but a lot of times the field bindweed will have lobed cotyledons. They're not as deeply lobed as those that we saw on the ivy leaf morning glory, but typically you'll have a little bit of an indentation at the tip. And then the leaves start to develop into the characteristic arrowhead-shaped leaves that we find with the field bindweed. We have two bindweeds here in Iowa, field and hedge bindweed. The field bindweed can be more difficult to manage, but its leaves tend to be smaller. But we won't try to differentiate those in this video. So those are two vines in the morning glory family. The third one we're going to talk about is wild buckwheat, and it's actually in the Polygonaceae or the smartweed family. But a lot of people mistake wild buckwheat for one of the morning glories or bindweed because it is a vine and it has arrowhead-shaped leaves typical of the bindweeds. But as a seedling, and this one is an annual, it has cotyledons that are unlike those of the Convolvulaceae. They're long, elliptical in shape here. And then we see we have the leaves coming off, an arrowhead-shaped leaf. And if we had a hand lens, we could look at where that petiole is joining the stem and see the ochrea. And the ochrea is a little membrane structure that all members of the smartweed family have. And so wild buckwheat, we tend to find it. It can appear in crop fields. It's more of a problem as you move north and west. So it's a bigger problem up in North Dakota than it is here in Iowa. But we find it in gardens and occasionally in crop fields. So those are three vines. They all have unique characteristics that once you become familiar with, you should be able to easily identify them.